Hello and welcome. I'm István from Project Discovery, and today I will showcase the first two versions of the Nuclei Burp extension. The goal of these releases were to make Nuclei template creation more accessible to those who are new to Nuclei, but also to fit the needs of existing users by automating repetitive actions to boost productivity. I will show you how to install, configure, then use this plugin to generate and execute templates by focusing on the common use cases. As a prerequisite, you will need to have Nuclei installed. If you're not familiar with Nuclei, please visit the official GitHub project or the nuclei.projectdiscovery.io webpage. In short, it is a fast, customizable and widely used open source vulnerability scanner that relies on YAML-based detection rules. A Nuclei binary can be downloaded from GitHub by navigating to the Project Discovery organization, then selecting the first pinned repository. Under the releases at the assets section, you will find builds suitable for all major architecture and operating system types. If you have Golang installed, you can simply use the go install command found under the install section. In order to obtain a copy of the plugin, go to Releases, choose the latest version, scroll down to Assets, and download the Java archive. Alternatively, if you want to try the latest changes, you can also build the plugin yourself using Maven. To load the plugin, open BurpSuite, navigate to the Extender tab, click on the Add button, and finally point at the jar file. Once the plugin is successfully loaded, a new tab named Nuclei appears. If BurpSuite is started using the portable jar file, the plugin will try to fill in the configurations automatically. Since I have started the Burp binary, the process does not have access to my path variables, hence I have to manually set the location of my Nuclei binary. Usually go install saves the binary under the go path /bin/nuclei. But if your go path is added to your path variable, you can also use the which command to get its absolute location. The template save path is calculated based on the default Nuclei installation, and the template author field is populated with the currently logged in username. The dedicated window checkbox controls whether the generated template should appear in a separate window at creation or next to the configuration tab. The plugin can help you generate templates from requests and responses, either from proxy history, the repeater tab, or the intruder tabs. Let's see a couple of different use cases. First, I'm going to select a request, highlight the part of the response I'm interested in, right-click, hover over extensions, Nuclei, and finally select generate template. Using the selection and the HTTP response status code, the plugin generates a template. These values are transformed into word and status matchers, while the location of the highlighted string is reflected in the parse attribute. The UI consists of three main areas: the command line field, the template editor, and the output panel. Once the template is generated, it populates the command line field so the template can be tested instantly. This can be achieved by hitting Enter, Control Enter, or by clicking the Execute button. The input field enables the execution of any command. If the Nuclei path is configured correctly, there is no need to introduce the absolute path anymore. The executed commands are saved and are filterable within the current session. The UI supports multiple keyboard shortcuts to improve productivity. You can focus the input field using Ctrl-L, the same way as you would navigate to your browser's address bar. With Ctrl-Shift-E, you can go back to the template editor, and you can increase or decrease the font size using Ctrl-plus and minus key combinations. Ctrl-R displays the CLI flag helper to enable searching for the available command line arguments. The filtering works on the flag description also, so you don't need to remember the exact name of the arguments anymore. These hotkey combinations are listed under the help shortcuts. The tab support made possible to add new requests and matchers to previously generated templates. Besides simple word matchers, you can create binary matchers as well by selecting a snippet from a response containing known ASCII characters. In order to create templates using requests, select one or more of them and either generate a new template or add them to an existing one. Highlighting a snippet from a request also enables generating templates with multiple payloads. Since the request editor does not support multi-selection, the attack type will be set to battering ram, which is the current default for Nuclei. Slightly more complicated request templates can be created using the intruder functionality. Mark multiple substrings and select one of the desired attack types from the context menu. In the generated template, you can add multiple payloads for each parameter manually, or you can reference them from a file. Besides the custom syntax highlighting, the template editor also supports basic code completion. If you need help with the syntax, you can access the documentation from the File menu or by pressing F1. Classification information can be inserted manually from the context menu or by providing a valid CVE ID. Once you're done with the template, make sure to provide a valid, unique ID. When you save the template, the code will auto-suggest the ID as the file name and will update the path within the input field. After every change when you hit execute, the template will be resaved. Previously generated templates that were not explicitly saved or those that are stored within the temp folder will be deleted at the end of the session. Now let's see a real-life example where I create a template assisted by this extension. As an example, I'm going to use a SQL injection vulnerability found in Zebbix. To create the environment, I've used an image from the Volhub project, which also contains a Python exploit. Since it's never a good idea to blindly execute payloads from the internet, I will first quickly go through the code, at least on a high level, to make sure it does what it promises. By looking at the code, we can see that the script makes a request against the index page of the target host, retrieves the session ID from the response cookie, posts it to the login page, crafts a malicious URL that contains the actual payload, then at the end verifies if the attack was successful or not. Even though the exact same steps can be achieved using Nuclei templates, for the sake of this demonstration, I'll be using a slightly improved version of the exploit. By looking at the differences, we can see that the code is identical for the most parts. The main difference is that the improved version targets another endpoint which doesn't require a session, hence reducing the number of requests from 3 to 1, therefore making it more efficient when running it against a large number of hosts. Now that we know that the exploit is safe to be executed, we can set up an HTTP proxy environmental variable to point to my BurpSuite proxy address. This will help us analyze the request made against the target and use the response to generate a template. Going through the request, we can confirm our initial hypothesis. The username and the IP address in the response confirms the presence of the vulnerability. We can use this error message to create our matcher. By executing the template a couple of times, we can make sure that it works reliably. If yes, there's nothing left but to fill in the metadata, save it, and then start executing it against your environments or bug bounty targets. Since this vulnerability has an associated CVE, updating the template information can be done in an automated fashion. Notice how the template ID, severity, description, references, and tag fields got updated. Now that you have a shiny new template, don't forget to give back to the community by creating a PR in the Nuclei templates repository. These were the most important features of the version 1.1 of the plugin. I hope it will help you improve your productivity and make template creation slightly faster. If you have any questions or feedback, reach out to me on Twitter or on the Project Discovery's Discord server, which contains a dedicated channel for this plugin. For feature requests and bugs, please use the GitHub issues.